Coming up.
Watch Dogs 2 is gash. Outlast 2, shit. Game of Sex, genital jousting, and Keely on Kojima's cock again. So stick around, and we're going to be doing some stuff, innit?
So that's lots of things. It's all very sexual, and today...
Not new releases, we're going to go.
Oh, where are we?
Abuse the news. Oh. I can make this bigger.
Is there any dodgy fucker behind me?
There's somebody choking a chicken.
Weird.
So here we are in Chinky Chunky China Land. That's racist.
With a Russian hat, which is also racist.
Yeah, that's wild. When in Rome.
Or Russia.
or any former Soviets or communist nation.
Hello. Right. Welcome. Ramble, episode 87.
87!
Or Shoes.
Shoes.
And I've got Stangs.
Stangs. Mustang Sally's.
I'm going to abuse the news. And it's kind of sexual today.
I've
sprinkled in some normalness because it did get a bit too weird. So I've tried to sprinkle normalness in between the craziness.
Okay.
So the first bit of craziness is Outlast number 2.
Number 2.
As in?
Going to the toilet for a number.
It seems they're quite concerned that people might shit themselves playing this game.
Oh, wow.
Okay. It's also done in jest, but apparently this is really happening. It's a Kickstarter, and what they're doing, they're giving you some adult nappies that you can wear when you play the game. Now, there's quite a funny trailer on Kickstarter, so go and check that out. I don't know how much they want for it, because they didn't have the details. I didn't get a chance to click the link. It is a funny trailer. What they call underscares.
Alright, okay. That's as in underwear.
Scares.
But if you're scared.
Yeah, apparently they're washable, rewashable.
Rewashable.
So if you do shit yourself while playing the game, it's alright. If you support them on Kickstarter, I assume you have to put a certain amount in, but you'll get the key for the game on Steam when it comes out. So you're kind of buying the game, I suppose. Having a nappy is the bonus. And they're sort of fashioned in a style of, they've got the symbols on. It's got a nightlight on it.
You know what's really, really fucked up?
Might have a pocket, I don't know.
If I had one, I'd have to try and use
You'd
it.
You'd have to wear it while playing.
I'd have to use it.
Or try and shit it.
I'd have to use and see whether my adult brain goes, nah, mate. Nah, mate.
Wrong, yeah.
Nah.
Yeah.
Nah.
I kind of want to try that. Could I actually shit in a nappy now? Or would my brain just go,
because when you're a baby, it's just happening. It's like, oh, I'm pooing. Anyway, I'm weighing. And then you get told, like, when you need, you go there, and then it gets ingrained, like, I don't shit.
So, yeah, I don't do that anymore. Yeah. Stop shitting yourself, unless I'm really, really drunk.
Hmm.
Then it's okay.
Yeah, it's a bit like, there's a neuro blocker in your head, that while having sex, if you're in the flows of...
told you it was going to be sexual. Yeah.
You can't piss.
No.
You cannot piss.
No, you can't piss. I've tried. I've tried to piss. Can't do it.
But I can't say I've tried.
So sorry for all requests of pissing.
No,
I just can't do it.
Yeah, you literally have to stop. You can't be going dong, 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 dong.
Yeah, yeah.
You can't. There's a neuro.
I think it's the same when you sleep. People still piss themselves, but there's some that... Oh, that's why you wake up with an hard on.
Is it one of the reasons?
Yeah, that's why you wake up with an iron on.
Oh, right. Okay.
If you wake up with an iron on.
Yeah, if you're a woman and you're
here. I don't know why. I mean, they piss when they laugh, don't they, women all the time?
Yeah,
whenever you see a woman laugh, she's pissing. True story. Google it.
Google it. Even if you're a woman, trust. Believe.
Yeah, believe me. If it's not happening, there's something wrong with you.
But yeah, I say, if I did have one of those nappies. I wouldn't tell anybody I'm doing it, because I've just said it now, I'm not getting one. Or maybe I am getting one. But I would have to try it. I'd have to.
I don't know if I could go that far.
I'd put it on and be like...
Why don't you try shitting yourself now?
No, because I haven't got a nappy.
What if it was like
that? Because that's the comfort zone, isn't it?
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
That's the safety.
Safety, yeah.
Safety.
I'm allowed to shit.
I'm allowed to now, yeah.
But what if it was one of the shits that you did the other day at work that was like... That big.
Oh, that fucking long.
Yeah, I mean, the no nappy is going to fucking hold that.
I'll probably rip through it. But yeah, so. Gaming news.
So, yeah, that's so you get yourself a nappy.
Yeah, that's alright.
What's it called? Yeah.
Underscores, yeah.
Yeah.
So that's on Kickstarter.
Yeah, do that. Kickstarter.
Right.
Kickstarter nappy. But washable though.
Oh, that's all right.
Like, if you shit in it, do you really want to wash it again afterwards? That's what you paid for.
I tell you, it all depends on if I was sat there playing it and I'm like, and then shit, and I go, that was surprisingly convenient. I might endeavour to wash it.
I might get too comfortable with this. Yeah.
Like, oh, I might buy some more.
Start buying some normal nappies. Yeah. Fucking hell. Right, that's something to look forward to when we're older, at least.
Merry
even
Christmas.
If we don't do this.
Merry Shitmas.
Resident Evil 7 House Edition. Sticking with horror, but not poo.
Might shit yourself.
You might shit yourself playing this game, especially in the horror. That'll be fucking terrifying. But you get like a little replica house, 8 inches.
Right.
It's of the what is it? What they call the Baker's or something? It's the Baker Mansion house, and it's a music box.
Mm.
And when the music plays, there's little LEDs in there that do whatever they're doing. It's $180, 24th of January, which is when the game comes out. There's a little scrolled note in there, a metal case for the game, dummy finger, in the demo. I think that's like a USB. That comes in a video. Because it's like a video
VHS thing.
VHS thing. Yeah, so you can do that. You can get that if you want. This is from an American site, and it's exclusive to GameStop. So I assume it's coming here.
I thought you were going to say Game then, because grand all of a sudden.
I think it will be Game, and I think, because I think that's our equivalent, isn't it?
Yeah.
Game. I think it'll be over here and exclusive to Game, and I don't know how much it is. Sorry.
He is.
Right, watch penises and vaginas do.
Oi, oi, chicken fucking boy.
Chicken fucker.
Hi, Chris.
Yeah, Watch Dogs 2. So, it's got vaginas in it.
Yeah, only on one NPC, though.
Yes.
I mean, very detailed as well.
It's got penises in it. Yeah, obviously, one of the guys has drawn a very... Instead of, because I think these were Barbie doll mold, don't they, really?
Yeah, they do, yeah.
But for some reason, they definitely didn't with the guys, because there's a guy that just pisses on a wall. He's obviously part of the game.
Yeah, it was just that wall.
Someone snuck a vagina in there. This is a sneaky vagina.
Have you seen this sneaky vagina?
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's a cutout in underwear.
Yeah, yeah.
Has it, and you're like, well...
Yeah. It's easy access underwear, if you know what I mean by that. You can see the vagina.
And I'm not terribly
she
offended
got blown
by
up.
It. Yeah, she got bought. Somebody killed this girl and then had a look. Like, oh,
well, this model's got a vagina, but the rest of them.
Genuine vagina. Yeah,
the rest of them don't. So, what happened there is a guy, the first person that spotted it, shared it via PlayStation Share button.
Yeah, yeah.
And then he got banned for 30 days.
Because Sony's retarded.
And it's like, well, it's a share button. What the fuck?
Share button of a game, shared a game. It's in a game. I'm sharing this game.
So
banned.
It must be some policy in there that's like, kids might see it or whatever. So that's that. But it's only 30 days, which is annoying still.
Yes, of course it's annoying.
And that's an online game as well, isn't it?
You can play, yeah, certain online aspects to it and stuff.
Yeah, but it's still, it's notorious now because they spotted that. So what they're doing, they're going to update it and they're going to remove said vagina. But the penises will still be there.
Vagina gate.
Sexist. That's what that is.
That's clearly what it is.
It's clearly sexist.
It's clearly sexist.
I don't know what's more offensive, a vagina or a penis.
I find penises more offensive.
Yeah. Horrible.
But that's not like a homophobic thing. I just find them more offensive.
Well, you've got a penis.
Yeah.
So you'd be,
and it offends me all the
time. You'd be offended at your own penis. But yeah, I don't want to see penises everywhere. But vaginas everywhere is fine.
Yeah, it's nice.
We all like
bacon butties.
No, I'm not bothered about seeing it either, but it just seems silly to get rid of one.
Yeah, it does. It's preposterous.
But anyway, whatever, doesn't matter anymore on there.
Did make that game a little bit more interesting to me, and now I know it's been patched out. I'm not interested.
Yeah, well, maybe they'll allow mods on that game. Put vaginas on everything.
Ubisoft
then.
Won't allow mods on games. Ubisoft did pricks like that.
Unlikely. Yeah. Unlikely.
Very unlikely.
And also, side note, the sales are lower, a lot lower than Watch Dogs 1, which seems to be a theme lately, unless you're Battlefield 1 and you're alright.
You're smashing it.
I suppose they changed it quite a lot, didn't they? So maybe that's
Well, they did and they didn't, though. To be fair, it's still.
Changed the settings. And I think people jumped Call of Duty and flipped to that, so I think that's part of it as well.
I don't know if you got this, but Tesco at the moment is selling the brand new Call of Duty for $29.99.
Why?
So I think that might be down to how little, how it's not as selling as well, but they're like,
well, Black Friday,
it's a big, yeah, I know it's a big game, so it's good.
There's a lot of Fridays around Black Friday, isn't there?
Yeah, there's a lot, it's because Britain can't do it right. That's why, because it's not a British thing. So it's like, by Friday, it's traditionally, it's only been over for fucking 7 years
I won't set dates of when Black Friday is. I figured it'd just be a Friday.
No, well, I thought it was the last Friday in November, last shopping Friday in November
or something. Something to do with some tax things or something. Like stock. I don't know.
Flaccid penis offend me more than bonkons. Yeah.
Yeah.
The reason why they offend me more than bonkons is because when I see a flaccid penis, which is clearly twice the size of my erect penis,
that's insulting.
That scares me.
Yeah.
And
it makes you feel more lack of vagina.
What games should do to make you more inclusive is they should give everybody a walnut whip penis.
Yeah.
And then I'd be like, yeah, I'm bigger than him.
Yeah.
Look at Kratos there with his walnut whip.
That would be brilliant.
Like, oh yeah, you're fighting for charity. Fuck off. Normal men are better.
All your heroes are like pinpricks.
Yeah. Steads that they're on.
Sales are down on that as well, so I don't know why that's happening.
Yes.
These are decent games that are not...
Apparently Watch Dogs 2 is actually pretty damn good, but...
Dishonored 2, that sales were down, and Call of Duty down, and they've actually changed that as well, and I can't remember if it's supposed to be any good or not, I don't know, but... I don't know, it's just weird, isn't it? Is it sequel fatigue, or...
Well, I don't know, with Call of Duty...
Are we all skint?
I think it's skintness.
We want something new? Or are we all just playing Battlefield?
I don't know, I'm not playing Battlefield, I can't... justify buying it, because I know I'll enjoy it for a bit, the mechanics will be nice, but ultimately it's going to be the same game as all over Battlefield. Just, it's got a World War One setting.
It's got a different skin.
Fucking hell, give me that skin.
And big balloons.
Walnut with an outboard motor. Walnut whips. Concertinaed. Gunnile.
It's that little nut on the end though, isn't it?
The walnut.
Yeah. That clitoris on your penis.
Yeah.
An ugly one,
yeah. Bad one.
Unless your clitoris looks like that.
In which case, that's perfectly fine. No, it's honestly, it's normal.
It's a rose.
Honestly, you're a princess.
Mario, run!
Are we making this one sexual then?
No, this one's alright. I think I've mentioned this before, but I'll mention it again. December the 15th, it's coming out on your iPhone, Android later. The price is £8. Or $10. Or you can just play it for free, but you get three modes that you can play. I assume it's just probably the first level and
or
all
if
the
you've
modes.
Got an Android phone. Yeah.
Well, when it comes out on Android, because it's exclusive for the moment.
Okay. What you do is you download it on Android, and then as soon as it's finished downloading, you say, "I don't want to play this anymore. I want a refund." As soon as you ask for a refund, you turn your internet off.
Somebody did that.
I did that with Shadowrun. Yeah. I went, "I don't want it anymore." And as soon as you click, I don't want it anymore, turn your internet off, so it doesn't disable
it. Switch
it
off, yeah.
And what it then does is, the next time you go online, you've still got your game, but you've got your refund as well.
Ta-da! Top tips,
Top
Mr. Kielsis.
Yeah. Thieving bastard.
Nintendo Mini, briefly mentioned this last week, but I forgot about it, really. So what's happened is, it sold the fuck out very quickly. It's selling on eBay at an average of £185.
Jesus fuck Christ.
And it sells out in seconds when people put it up.
Somebody I met on Saturday night said that his sister had got one. And I said, tell her to sell it.
Yeah.
And he went, I think she spent 120 odd quid on it.
Don't sell it.
That's why I said, don't sell it.
Yeah, she's obviously wanted it for the extra. What was that? Bleepy bleeps, bleepy blops. And the Famicom Mini, I think they're called classic minis actually, but you know what I mean, in Japan is, I don't know if it's sold out, maybe they had some reasonable stock on that, but it's selling a lot. It's outselling PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Pro, which the combined sales, it's selling three times more than that.
Shit, I don't.
They're the second. Which is hilarious.
It is hilarious. Yeah.
So yeah, that's happening. Enjoy that. Fucking hell, I wish I'd have got that. Gamer sex. We're going back to the gutter. Good
to
move.
The clutter gutter.
The clutter gutter.
Sticking with vaginas now.
It's good news for gamers.
Is it fresh out of the box?
Fresh out of the box. They did ask some boxes actually, or ladies.
A lady.
So it was a little survey, nothing completely official, but it was a survey on some kind of money website, I think something to do with vouchers or somewhere, where they asked women in this survey what their partners did, and one of the questions was about sex. So it's how would you describe your partner, and you had some options. You had like, these were your options: gamer, hipster, trendsetter, nerd, gym goer, or dad.
That last one makes me...
That's a bit weird.
A little weird.
I would describe my sexual partner as dad.
Dad. Dad is fucked. Dad is really fucked.
He's fucked, yeah. Luckily, he's at the bottom of the list for sex. But he's still doing alright.
Fucking hell. What a fucking bizarre choice.
Right.
I'm surprised brother or second cousin isn't in there. How would you describe your sexual partner? Relative.
Reluctant. Right, so, here's the breakdown. This is how many times each of these groups of people have sex per week.
Oh, okay then.
So, if your sexual partner is a gamer, six times a week.
I need to dispute this.
So do I.
I'm a gamer. And I have it at least zero times a week.
Or six times a day. Come on.
So, if I'm playing GTA, I'll get nailed all the time.
It's just fucking madness. Now, at first, I didn't read it properly, and I thought, this will just be guys. Gamers are always seen as a bit fucking nerdy or shit. So there's this stereotype that's
there is, which
incorrect.
Is still hanging on for some strange reason.
Yeah, yeah. It's very strange. So I thought maybe it's the guys just saying, oh yeah, I'll shag all the time, putting six or whatever, or seven. But it's the girlfriends that are doing it. They won't give a fuck. They're just shopping and filling out surveys. So I feel like there's some truth to it. But obviously not in our cases. So they do it six times. Hipsters. Four times per week. Trendsetters.
Okay, so this is what we should be doing.
Three times per week.
Three times a week. Trendsetters, you say? They're right.
They're trendsetters.
They're right.
Which is also the same as nerds. They do it three times a week. Gym goers.
They don't have enough time to fuck.
Too busy fucking themselves.
Or looking in the mirror going, yeah.
I wish I could
American
fuck
psycho,
myself.
American Psycho. Like, oh, that's right.
I think that's it. They once a week. And then at the bottom of the list is people that fuck their dads, which is once every 2 weeks, apparently.
Whenever he comes round for tea.
It just says dad. Oh, how would you describe your...
fucking weird, man.
Dad.
That's weird as fuck.
How would you describe your sexual partner? Dad.
Oh, I find that really odd.
Anyway.
That's really fucking odd.
More fucked up.
They would have had a focus group to go, right, we need some groups here. We need some groups here. Yeah, somebody's gone, dad.
I think...
What?
Well, yeah, they didn't really think it through, I don't think.
Dad, put dad in
just
there.
Thought, oh, why no, he's like,
dad?
His daddy.
You'll be surprised at how many people fuck dads. What?
I am surprised, actually. Once every 2 weeks.
He's a... I mean, congratulations, I suppose, if you're born somebody. No, I can't even take it.
We're stopping there. We go on.
I'll draw a line on the edge. I'll draw a line
that's
on
over
that
the
one.
Edge. Right, onto lighter news. Genital jousting.
Boom! I watched that and went, what the fuck? But got strangely aroused while watching it. I'm like, oh wow.
So, if you don't know what that is, it's a game.
I reckon there'll be a group out there that will be protesting it, calling it homophobic or some shit like that.
Maybe
I reckon
find a way,
that's
yeah.
where they're gonna go.
Maybe they'll find a way, because it's a penis.
And the bumhole.
I'll describe it in a sec. I'll get through the boring stuff first. It's a new game. It's by the guys that did Broforce.
Yeah.
It's those guys. Yeah, it's those guys.
Same people who did Mother Russia Bleeds.
Or did they do that as well?
And Hotline Miami. Well, they're publishers, you see.
So they've got a pedigree.
Yeah, they have. Yeah. No, they're all right. Devolver Digital are a publisher, so you go there, and they're actually happy for you to stream their games, and because they see it as promotion. Even if you hate those games, you like you're reviewing it and stuff.
I like that.
They're
attitude.
Actually really, really good.
I like that attitude.
They're a cool publisher.
So at the moment, you can get that now. It's on Steam Early Access.
Early Access into the
world. Online and local multiplayer. It's £4 or $5. And so what it is, if you haven't seen it, we'll probably be able to see a video later.
Yeah,
but it's penises.
Peni.
Peni with balls. And they've got a bum hole somehow. Maybe it's just the bottom of the shaft.
A bum oil.
Yeah. And there's loads of you sort of moving them around.
Snaking around.
So snaking around 2D style. And you've got to put your penis head in the other penis's bum. And try and make as big a chain as possible, I think, is what's going on.
I think that's what you meant to do, yeah.
Yeah. It's very odd.
It's a bit like, from what I could get from it, it's a bit like British Bulldogs. Right, so you all start off away, right?
Yeah.
And as soon as you fuck somebody, right, you've got a point.
You're
committed. No, it's a bit like musical chairs, sorry, because you're timed. So, like, if somebody makes a link and you're a penis just outside, you can't enter somebody, then you don't get any points.
Yeah.
So that's it's like that.
We'll see it in a bit anyway. Yeah. We'll see that later. Voice of the Peoples later on.
In the Voice of the Peoples.
That's that. right, what else have we got? Internet says Zelda will miss its launch. Now, these are a couple of very good sources.
I like sources.
Sources. And what it is what they're saying is the localization still isn't finished. The translation, the languages, methinks, and it's going to continue until just after 2016, which sounds fine because it's supposed to come out in March apparently. Mm-hmm. But the problem there is once they've done all the localization, then they do the testing, and they reckon the testing for bugs and shit is going to take 4 to 6 months.
Jesus titty.
This game is huge. Apparently, it's as big as. It's bigger than Twilight Princess, Wind Waker, Skyward Sword, some of the shit put together.
Rightio.
So it's going to take a long time to find all the bugs. So they're reckoning it's going to be April, June,
right.
Something like that.
Okay.
But this is still a rumour, but these are sources that seem to get it. Right.
So is it fully voiced then? Or is it just text?
I don't think it. I think it'll be mainly text.
Is it just text? It shouldn't really. I mean, okay, I say it shouldn't
really.
We'll
have to translate it all.
Yeah, but
I don't know how much they've got.
Well, while they were making it, every line of text should have been translated there and then.
As they were going.
That's how I'd do it. If I had to do something, it'd be like, right.
You'd have a better gist of where you're at then.
I'd be like, right, well, this is this conversation. I'd finish a conversation.
Yeah. And have a team just doing it
outside.
Yeah,
and then they're like, right, well, that's the conversation. You guys work on that, right, okay, Mr. Chris is saying, I think that the bus hole violation is a way of disabling an opponent.
Oh.
Well.
Ah. Never tried it, but maybe that does work.
Maybe it does disable. Maybe that's what the police should do.
Freeze! Oof! Get on the ground! Hands behind your head. Get on the ground, that's where they do it.
Yeah.
It's all making sense now. Kojima! Kojima news. What, Jeff Keighley sucks Kojima off again. We'll see. He's a big fan, the best buddies.
Yeah.
As you can tell, you watch the Game Awards, which will be, it's 1st of December, and it's going to be in VR as well. You can watch the Game Awards in VR. The first Game Awards was good. The second one was...
How can Kojima win... How did he win so many awards? Oh, he's on... It's on the panel.
Well, he couldn't go, could he, to the last one because Konami said
they banned him.
No, and it caused a bit of drama and it was a bit of a thing. Well, he's coming to this one and he's got an award, Industry Icon.
Yeah, because he's done fuck all since the last one. He's taking the piss, though, isn't
he?
You don't find
he's one of them that just arrives and people just jizz all over him and. Right, lose.
Night 2 hasn't been out for a while. It's like fucking Peter Kay getting 2016's best comedy act. And he hasn't done anything in 2016. Well, he hasn't, but it's just
Yeah,
what are you doing, man?
Yeah, I don't know.
It's
yeah.
bullshit.
It's who you know.
It is, but the Jeff Keighley are a little bit upset about the last Gaming Awards because he were upset with how people reacted to it because he had to get loads of funding from several like Ubisoft and EA yeah. and all this kind of stuff. So he was like, kind of like,
well, you've got him,
everybody
you?
Is everybody's down on me because like EA constantly had Star Wars Battlefront in the background. Every time you talk yeah. to him, you're like, mate, that's not actually
it works to
good,
yeah.
And
but I mean, just seeing it all the time,
and it
wasn't
just terrible.
Good.
And then like Kojima got his award, and I can sort of semi. Get it, yeah, alright, big
well, it was kind of cool then, because
now,
it was drama. But
now, it's like, you have not done anything for a year, you've literally done nothing, you've released a trailer for Death Stranding.
But he's an icon of Showman Games, because you take the piss out of him, haven't we?
Yeah.
So, give him that, give him Showman Games.
It's because of Jeff Keighley, we take the piss out of
yeah,
him.
Yeah, this is
week.
Pretty much where it started, yeah. So it's gone full circle, so
yeah,
now we can
yeah.
do for another year after this one.
That's a good point.
It
yeah.
will never end. Yeah, a bit like Hunter and other things. RPG Golf. And,
RPG Golf will never end.
Staples, you know. Staples of Showman Games. Right, so what's next?
What's next? Nothing as dramatic as... It's only this week's games.
I don't believe it.
It's only...
Unbelievable.
This week's games.
If we've missed any games, let us know. But give us a chance to read them out first, obviously.
Might be able to read a bit now. Right, so I'll have to scroll down because I didn't bother doing this before on. So what day are we on? 21st.
I have no idea.
Yeah, we're on 21st.
What day is it? Oh, it's Monday. It must be Monday.
Let's ramble on. It's Monday time. We
should change Monday to just ramble on.
They should do. Well, I did apply to that, but what happened was everybody else was petitioning for a repeat Brexit vote, so I'm like.
Yeah, there's so many petitions, so why can't we have a petition for Ramble On Day?
Honestly, like there was somebody, Michael Fletcher, who runs a movie gaming website, he's a freelance writer. I saw a petition coming up saying, the government petition asking for people to sign it so that it forces companies to pay freelance writers. Now the thing is, when you enter into a contract, if
all
you
right,
say,
yeah.
you pay me whenever, or when that's been published, or whatever, then you have all the legal rights to then take that person to court anyway. You don't need the government to step in, because that was a contract, and that comes under the contract laws. So
yeah.
I'm like, so that...
If they're not paying you, they're doing something wrong.
So that's another petition that's going to the government, that the government have to look at, read, and go, no,
do you
right,
think there's a
man
there, just putting them all in bin?
Well, what do they do? They go through a certain amount of, like, even before they go to Parliament, there's several people that look at them and go, like, is this viable? Shall we talk about this?
Yeah.
So, people get paid to sit there when I'd rather them run the fucking country.
Yeah.
Right? These people, it's like, another shit one.
It's too easy to sign them as well
it's,
now.
It's
I think people
ridiculous.
Should have to go out on the street. I mean, we're going off track.
Yeah,
here.
We are going.
But yeah, you go out on the street.
There's good games coming out this week, that's why.
No games. Yeah, you should have to go out on the street and get signatures. That way you really mean it.
Yeah.
It's like voting on Facebook. It means fuck off.
Yeah, it means absolutely fuck off.
Because you don't have to put the effort in. Or think about it.
Or think about it.
Anyway, games.
Okay, we've got Pash. Sir Pash. Right, this week. Nothing is out this week.
I think we need a new list.
Yeah, we probably do, but no, it's out this week, apparently, according to that, so let's just change the music up then. No, literally nothing. The next game is...
What's out, Bash?
Yeah, what's out?
Quickly, put them all up there.
In fact, we don't need music for this section, do we?
No, because there may be some videos I do... Mm. Voice of the peoples.
Yeah, we're going to do a bit of voice of peoples now. So,
is what's going to happen now?
It's one of them things which it's going to be rather difficult.
Just do this thing.
Group this.
Might go in the void for a bit, or no, we don't go in the void now, do we?
No, we don't go into the void. We don't twitch, and we don't go into the void. So what we just do is we should just be able to press that.
Ah, we've avoided the void.
And then
there is a bit of void.
There's a void in the background. Yeah,
but then, just needs to move. A void. Void.
There we go. And then that's actually capturing the wrong thing, so refresh.
Bear with it.
And that should be... That's not working.
Not working.
You know what it's like.
This is the bit.
This is always the bit.
This is the bit where we get the jitters.
Done.
There we go. Magic.
Done.
Right. Try and move our way out a bit so you can see. And oh, as it happens, there's the Resident Evil 7 house... That somebody's
that Jack built.
Yeah, which is brilliant. Thank you.
Jay Patel. Yeah. Look at that.
It looks pretty sweet, doesn't it?
It does look pretty cool, actually, yeah.
So, yeah, that's a music house. Little lights come on. It goes in time with the music.
Right.
The lights, apparently. So, that's a nice little thing. Finger there and some little bits of guff.
Yeah, the finger's there, isn't it?
Yeah, that's a USB.
It's a finger. Oh, it's my finger.
I don't. It's the game's theme music, which I can't remember what it is.
It's.
That'll be annoying.
Surprise! You're dead! Look at my eyes!
Turn it into Doom.
Yeah. It's, so that's how it is, yeah, because what it does is because it's such a slow tune,
yeah,
it creeps into your head.
Right.
And builds up the atmosphere. Yeah, that's what. So, it does look pretty cool, so.
So that's that. Smart. I don't know if it's worth the cash.
Mr. Shoes.
Some games. Titanfall 2.
Slashed. HMV. I didn't know HMV existed.
It doesn't where we are anymore. Oh. No.
Is it just online then?
I think they might have got rid of all stores. Maybe they've got some big ones.
Yeah.
Maybe they've still got one in Preston or something.
Preston or
somebody mentions Preston
Liverpool.
On there.
Well, we've got here, right? Amnesia Collection Play. Thank you. Right, we'll just
do this
quickly. No, I can't. If I make it bigger, it's probably gonna fuck everything up. Sod it. Right. So we have. Well, you can read that in bottom there. Right.
It's
here.
There.
Right.
Them here. Games. Them Wait a minute. We need a winner.
All right. Yeah, winner. Right, so we have Warhammer.
XP.
Okay. Darksiders. War Master Edition. Don't do Darksiders.
Sing.
No, sing. Final Fantasy 15. Ooh. Crew calling all units.
They're all a bit boring. Shit. Names.
I think I'm going to go with Amnesia Collection.
Yeah. Well, what's the dullest one?
Amnesia Collection. Dullest one is Crew calling all units.
Crew. What about November?
November 22nd. Remember that.
That's the winner. That's November's the winner this week.
So
£20, probably online. Maybe there's a store. There must be a store.
And this one here, this is what I was saying earlier on.
Coloured. Dude.
£29.99 at Tesco. It's for a PlayStation 1 and Xbox 4. So,
just copy it.
It's good. Good, you can get that now.
Cheap ass chips, considering it's brand new.
That's Michael Clark. It's good to see games we don't often see.
Yes,
popping up. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you very much. It's so good in the hood. This is beautiful. This is why gamers have more.
Dean Bean of Redpath, actually enjoying Elder Scrolls Online after the new update. Also looks gorgeous in 4K on the PS Pro.
Sweet.
So he's another one that's bought that useless console.
Yes, and then he'll have to upgrade to a Scorpio. Scorpion.
Yeah, Scorpio.
Yeah. Scorpio. Then.
Or the new Nintendo.
Well, you just get that anyway, I reckon. That's your side bitch.
PlayStation Pro.
Yeah. Great. So this is why gamers are having more sex, obviously.
It is, yeah.
Six times. I mean, you would. VR. Sex all the time.
If I was to have sex...
You can have sex and play Doom.
With my...
Or have sex with somebody else.
My ex-partner right now. It would probably look a little bit like... Doom in my eyes.
Shots fired.
And the and the sex would probably go.
Would that be your dick?
Yeah.
Or is it?
And then right at the bottom, I actually look up and I'll have Doom guy's face like. So looking around.
You could argue that is the inside of a vagina. And that
it is,
going
exactly.
In angrily.
Yeah.
A large vagina, or maybe just a very small penis. I don't know.
Just for Jude's sake, that was all for comedy purposes.
It's real.
It wasn't real.
So that's why we have it six times a week.
Yeah, because you don't have to look into the eyes of the dead love that you've been lying to each other, you've been having for so long. Instead, you can look into any game that you want.
Or just another woman.
Another woman. Right.
Controversial. It's like Black Mirror, isn't it?
It is a bit like Black Mirror. Exactly.
It's an episode of Black Mirror. We sort of do something like that. What's this? Oh, this is genital jousting. Allow me to present a penis.
Oof.
A jizzy one.
I like how that had a dress on.
They're actually kind of cute. Yeah, cute penises. Look, they're just having fun.
As soon as you bum them, they jizz.
Oh, is that where the jizz goes?
As soon as you bum them. Look at that massive one. It's absolutely like space race.
It looks like it might be strangely addictive. In a little shitty dick around kind of way.
Dick around, yeah.
Up to eight friends.
Playing football.
Football.
And then they bum each other while playing football. Right. Fuck you.
So nobody's playing football anymore. They're stopping sex.
Sex, see?
Penis bum sex.
It is a little bit ridiculous.
Wow.
Can't believe YouTubers allowed this. He just fucked a planet.
Did he? Oh,
he
missed
just
it.
He fucked a planet.
You're looking, but you're not looking. I was thinking. I can't multitask. I can't think and look at the same time. I go blind every time I think. It's like now I can't see anything.
It's all right then. But funny thing. Jim Sterling's episode today is
I just called that after I watched that, actually.
I watched that just before you turned up, and he does mention that, like, when talking about genitalia and stuff like that, he found it funny that he has done this. Well, that video right there is Jim Sterling Early Access trailer. He's allowed to monetize that.
But he can't do the one with a vagina.
But he can't do the one with tits.
Oh, it's another game.
It's a completely
different
game.
Where you're in a strip club.
Yeah.
And they've got tits.
And they're like, no.
Yeah.
Because that's a breach of...
Is that the just tits? That's a penis.
That's penises. Not only penises. Like, this actual penetration.
Yeah.
And ejaculate.
Yeah. Double standards.
It is double standards.
There'll be sexism somewhere. Come on, somewhere. Get social justice. Get on it.
We've got Tom O'Toole playing... is this Final Fantasy? World of Final Fantasy?
It's summer, yeah. Is it that. Some little site? I don't know. It's supposed to be some strange thing. So there's that, and he basically gets something that seems to uber level him up across the... board.
Yeah, it just levelled everything.
What does he put? I don't think I was supposed to catch
that. Not sure it wanted me to catch that one yet.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, well. It's kind of like if you get something that you're not supposed to get, or kill a beast that you're not supposed to, and you just level up to fuck. I think that's what's happened there.
That's amazing.
And is that from, it might be from PlayStation. I think he might have shared that from his PlayStation.
Yeah, shared that from PlayStation. So
if there's any vaginas in there, he might
Well, there
is.
He's a cunt for having a PlayStation.
There is that.
Jogs, see? Ooh, bit of rivalry. I'm an Xbox guy.
Console wars.
Oh. Whew. Bring me back out then.
I got really angry.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, unnecessarily. Oh, God. God.
Right.
And then we'll have a retro guy in corner going, retro. Right, okay. So, yeah, that's a bit weird. Nice.
Some Black Friday deals there, all conveniently in one place.
If Black Lives Matter...
Does Black Friday matter?
Does Black Friday matter?
I think 10% goes towards...
Fuck off. Honestly, with the world that the way that the world's going right now, I was fucking convinced. If you were on a straight face, am I?
Fuck off. No.
Oh, right. Okay.
Not that I'm aware of.
Fucking, I wouldn't be surprised if Sony's marketing team just go...
Oh, we'll do that.
We'll do that because we'll do obviously it. We're not offending anybody.
There's not enough.
Because nobody can argue.
There's not enough dead cops.
Alright, so yeah. Well, there we go. What have we got going on here? All Fridays matter. Well, you'd expect so, wouldn't you? Why don't we have a Yellow Friday?
Somebody got fired from saying that.
Why don't we have a Yellow Friday? Yellow Friday's where you go to town, right?
I was hoping you didn't say Chinatown.
No.
But then I just said it anyway.
No. Yeah. No, you go to town, right? And all prices have been ridiculously increased. And you're like, are you taking the piss?
Yes.
Are you taking the piss? Oh, I just want bread.
And it's yellow.
Yeah.
Like, taking the piss.
See, you made it racist. I made it...
I thought that's what he was going to say.
Yeah, see? And then White Friday, which is just white supremacists.
Can't say that.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
Fuck that.
I saw this in a rival group.
A rival? We have rivals.
Which we won't talk about. But... It's fucking horrible, isn't it?
Yeah, fuck that for a game of marbles.
I think it is called Cuddles.
Shit, that.
I just made that up. But if I had a spider like that, I would call it Cuddles.
Yeah, and it loves them.
What's this coming out of his ass?
They are the things that move the web.
Ah, right. Yeah,
that's what we...
Because I'm not used to seeing such a massive spider. I mean, so do they all have that, I assume?
It's not a spider, it's a...
It's a dog.
It's actually a tarantula, because spiders...
Spiders have teeth like that, right? Pincers. Yeah.
Right.
Whereas in tarantulas have fangs.
Ah.
And that's the main difference you walk with between shit. Them. But they're but yeah, so they're tarantula. That comes under the tarantula genus of, I think genus is the right word, of arachnids.
Mm.
Because they're all in the same thing as scorpions. Scorpions are the same as tarantulas to a degree and stuff like that. But there was. You ever meet Sam, Warren's ex-girlfriend? She runs a tattoo studio.
I don't remember. A dog grooming
studio. She loves the spiders and stuff. They have a Goliath spider, otherwise known as a bird-eating spider.
Right.
Right. And it's as big, if not bigger, than my hand.
Why is it called a bird-eating spider?
Because it eats fucking geese. It just grabs them by the neck.
You could have said like ostrich.
But yeah, it doesn't technically eat them. It's just,
it has the ability.
That's that word. It just named it that. But they had it in a glass. They have a glass coffee table. Mm. Right. A wooden coffee table with a recessed glass box in. Right?
Sweet.
So that became the, is it the avarian? Not avarian. That's for birds and stuff like that. The
spiderarium.
Spider. I can't remember what they call it now.
Arachnatarium.
I think it's a vivarium, isn't it?
Vivarium.
So had that, and the thing is it's just fucking sat there. Right?
But you're having your bro.
And she went, go on, you want to touch it? I went, you want a black eye? and she's like, no, it's alright, it'll be fine. So she moved the glass top. Right? I'm not good with these. And it decided to move, and I heard it.
Oh no.
I heard its footsteps. And at which point I thought, fuck that!
No, get rid of it.
Fuck it!
Get rid of it, burn it.
I remember our Warren had a Chilean pink toe tarantula.
Right, why is it called that?
Because it literally got pink toes, they look like skin.
Oh, right.
Yeah, it's from Chile.
I thought it might eat chili and pink toes.
That's fucking bizarre. I don't know how it survived for so long on such an exclusive diet. A terrarium. So,
thank you.
So when tarantulas and arachnids, they shed their skin, right? So one day we wove a web bed.
Right.
And then they stay until the skin, their exoskeleton, sort of goes a little bit hard. And inside they go quite soft because they're expanding and getting bigger.
Yeah.
And then it flips on its head and lies on this moist patch.
Right.
And then it pushes itself out of its head. Now the thing is the skin is an identical replica of a spider or a tarantula.
Wow, so it still has the colouring and stuff.
Yeah.
So it's in baby ones, but it's transparent.
You can move them. You can move it, and if you leave it until it dries, you can put it in a tax dance and shit like that. It looks
cool.
It's one for one replica. Right. Now
throw it at someone. That's what I
used to smoke the tweeds, and I don't like tarantula, and I was particularly fucked one day. And
having that
Warren knocks on my door.
Six times a week thing.
Yeah. Knocks on my door. And I'm like, right. So you're in. I'm like, yeah. And I had a sofa in my old room and stuff, if you were back in Chadwick. And he came in, he went, look at this. And it was there. And I'm stoned. Too stoned to move properly, but not too stoned to have a bit of a panic attack.
Well, that's generally when you're going to have a bit.
So he kept walking over to me, and he I shit myself.
Right, yeah, I would. You could have done with them diapers we were talking
about. Yeah, I would have done. I think I would have comfortably, diapers, without much issue, shit myself.
That's when you'll do, that's how we'll do it.
That's how we'll do it.
Can we have some spider skins, please? Yeah. And we'll do that, and he'll probably roll a joint with them skins.
His skins. Who said games aren't art? Great moments in gaming. Number 80, Exodus from the Earth. I haven't seen this video, so I'll have a quick gander.
Yeah, I don't know what it is.
Gander.
I thought it was going to be clips of great moments. But it just seems like a taking me out for my holiday. Relentlessly cheesy game. Frank, the
sun is very unstable. I like how they've all got the same shape head.
The Earth has only 20 years, Frank.
You know if you're cutting edge when you're out, though.
Oh, yeah.
20 years before the disaster?
I think, is it one guy doing all voices as well?
I don't know. I'm not aware of this game, so I don't get it.
The end of the world is coming, and we hardly even know each other.
Let's have sex six times a week. No, I don't.
Nothing really happens, I don't think. I didn't get all the way through it. I don't know, maybe you just need to know the game. I don't know. I feel like I'm missing something with that.
Yeah, so that happened.
And the things.
Jerick, and then I saw this today, and I'm having quite a lot of financial issues at the moment, and I thought the most unrealistic part of Skyrim is that my character isn't 50k in debt from the College of Winter. And I thought, yeah,
buy that.
Yeah,
well, you can't buy that.
Yeah,
don't have any money.
This is unrealistic. Yeah. Graham Daly with one of those existential questions.
Yeah,
I don't get it.
I don't think you can play SNES games on your 3DS, but you can on the new 3DS, if I remember correctly.
I do not on the marketplace, because I thought I had Link to the Past on my 3DS.
Maybe, but I think there might be a new set, or maybe that was the Game Boy Link's Awakening, I don't know. I don't know.
I mean, he sends me for a loop because my. Has he worded that wrong?
No, I think he's right. I vaguely remember something a while back that only SNES games were going to be on the new 3DS. I don't know why, because it seems silly.
Mm.
Because you'd imagine it can run on a normal 3DS as well.
Yeah, there's no reason why.
So, why are they using it for a selling point? I'd have to look into it. Maybe there's a reason. I don't know. Maybe I have to. I don't know. Is that some exclusive thing?
Rare black disc version of Dino Crisis PlayStation 1 PlayStation game with case and booklet on eBay for 99p. Not only new 3DS players SNES games. Thank you very much. Pash!
Thank you very much. Do we know why?
Is it a
bullshit reason? Like,
absolute reason.
Buy this, it's better.
Yeah, probably.
It might be one of them.
Dino Crisis is a classic. We have got a review of Dino Crisis via Mr. Kenny Haslam on the shopgames.co.uk website. If you want
check
to go
that out.
Check that shit out. Okay, so Call Off Duty, Mr. Chris.
Yeah.
Is there?
Yeah, Call Off Duty. Well, this is Oldham Town Centre, so if you want to get your exclusive Call of Off Duty.
Call off duty.
Call off duty.
Oi, what?
Good.
Go on.
Off. Why?
You're off duty.
Off duty.
Boom.
Get all kinds of marking.
Yeah, everything there. You get foglins.
I don't know what. Are they like shit goblins?
They're like boglins, but made out of bread.
Wow.
Yeah, they go off really easy.
Put them in fridge.
I made that up. You get shitty wrestling figures as well. They all had the same stance like that. Thumbs up, and
yeah, but when you're a kid, you're just like, I want that.
Wow, you get 10 of them in a packet for a quid, can I have them? Your mum's like, this shit, you'll break. I'm not bothering, you get them all and one arm's fall off, and painting's really bad.
Yeah, well, that's what I earned it anyway.
Yeah, that's what I did, yeah. Still love them anyway. Because Nintendo is the answer. Thank you very much,
yes,
Pash. That is cool.
I think you might be right there.
Return to Skyrim. Harry Partridge.
A bit of a song and a bit of a dance, I believe.
Let's have a bit of that on then, because I didn't like the Skyrim song.
It's very silly.
Oh, look, we've got...
It's not offensive enough for my taste. Yes, we've been working
on. By the nine, it's been 5 long years since I've come here, so I think I'm perfectly entitled to cry once here, and now I want beer.
And I need a mead, and thanks to this bucket, we don't have to buy one here.
I've just picked up a fresh bunch of sweet balls. Would you like one, dear?
I should head back to my hearth fire before the Thorn Guards start lecturing. But my belly's full and inventory's empty, so we better get adventuring. Pick up a weapon,
then pick a direction,
then pick a dungeon that we're entering. No fast travel, just treasuring every texture that's rendering. Living our memories and carving out some new ones.
With newer and shinier hardware, you can do whatever you want.
Is it just me or a mod made this world change in odd ways? My thoughts be dropping the snort and thought under the god rays. The shining of mountain water glistening,
twinkling,
falling,
twinkling,
dimpling out. I'm sure
hey, little pussy.
Hairs on end of your paws and tingling. My legacy, odyssey, energy, prophecy, better than ever. You're probably getting euphoric and wobbly and bedded pajamas, but it feels like ebony armor. It's godly. I am the dragonborn, and thus I'm dragging you back to my birthplace. I've got unfinished business. I never did the main quest in the first place. So many side missions, civil wars, guild and factions. How can I ever 100% again? They're filled with distractions, refractions and reflections, weapon sets and plaque collections, never ending. Harry, Pax, erection.
So, oops.
Think of the theme of penises.
All right, yeah. Well done. All good. Well done, sir. And then the cat's shitting it because he's like, oh, there he goes. He's done.
Too high.
Yeah, too high. Touch, chest, yeah. There we go. I'll get on shot.
Ah. Neck slits and chill. No idea what that means. Sex. Netflix and chill.
A equals sex.
So we got boy sex? Yeah, got again? Sex.
See? There we go. Fucking I was going to do a Netflix and chill stream.
6 times a week.
But I'm single, so Netflix and chill for me is literally put a film on.
Have a wank.
And have a wank. And cry.
Chuck cats out. Cry. Stop looking at me.
Stop looking at me. Stop judging me. Stop judging me.
This is another one, actually. This is voice sex.
This is this one. Oh, this one.
Sorry, just underneath. Oh, yeah. Tell me what you take from that.
It's my house bed, but it's hardly been used since my house just sleeps in your mum's bed instead.
Dan, what a fucking shocking revelation.
You coming to Pokemon lately?
Pokemon have just been wrong. $200 for Xbox One, 1 terabyte. Not bad.
Yeah.
Two games as well, winner.
Deals.
Let's go Broderick stuff. Michael Clark again. Literally 20 minutes of solid story. Yeah, I need to do this. This is a web-based...
Then some app on my phone and I got distracted, but I thought, yeah, I want to do this actually. I've saved it in my phone,
right?
So I'm going to do it, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to go back and try it out. Who've we got down here? We've got Ariane. This guy was on Epic Rap Battles of History 2. Yes, he was, wasn't he?
He sounded a bit like James Bond, wasn't he?
I think he played James Bond.
Right, yeah, it's just a little click game, isn't it?
It's a pick your own adventure thing, the book used to be.
It's on your phone or your laptop or whatever.
That's good.
So check that out.
I think we'll leave it on Black Lives Matter.
Black Friday Lives Matter.
Yeah, Black Friday. Keep making it racial.
Remember, 10% goes to nobody.
Nobody. Not even us. So on that bombshell,
we're going to impose.
Go back to China.
Back to Chinatown. We've got all our buddies here.
Chucking his chicken.
This is the Show Me Games China branch. They don't have the internet.
Take this table with us everywhere we go.
They just write it all down on a piece of paper. They're happy. They think they're contributing, but they're not.
Never.
But it's okay, we just let them choke the chicken. So, thanks for watching.
Thank you very much for watching.
Thanks for chatting.
Tings. Thank you to our Patreons out there. Thank you very much for that.
Yes.
You're helping the website stay alive, because I can't fucking afford it otherwise. Thanks a lot for that.
And check out all this stuff here. Well, it's also on Instagram, if you're into pictures and things. They're not dirty ones. Although I can
start showing some dirty ones. I've got a filthy finger.
Real life jousting.
Genital jousting. Yeah. If I didn't work, I'd go around and do a lot of little silly shitty mean things like asking women randomly whether they have sex with their dad. Going off.
Think you might get twatted, so it'd be worth it.
Yeah, it would be worth it. Yeah, it'd be all right. But you have a bit of physical fucking contact I've had with a woman.
It's only talk of sex. He's getting really frustrated.
Yeah,
he's gonna get angry now.
Well, what did he say? A hungry man always talks about food.
Ah. So me and Aaron are very hungry today.
Fucking starving.
Yeah. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If you want to send some sex to our PO box?
Yeah.
I'll take it. Don't care how old it is. If it's past its sell-by date or not. Ideally, if it has reached the best date.
Well.
See you later.
See you later.